Hi, this is Katie Burns with Live Well. This week we have Cara Sapp again with us, and we're having tea, and we're going to continue talking about the juggling act. And we all have stress in our life. We're all trying to figure out how to better plan and manage our schedule, because when we're juggling, the definition is the manipulation of objects. Mm-hmm. And we have the normal things that we do every day, and we have things that pop up.
Yes, they do.
That we have to address and figure out how to manage. So we're going to be telling some personal ways that we, you know, strategize, that we try and de-stress, and hopefully, you know, you guys can learn some helpful tips today. But where I want to begin is, first of all, thank you for bringing this tea.
Yes, you're very welcome.
Nice herbal tea is one of the ways that I de-stress. Make a cup of tea. The aroma is soothing to me. You know, sometimes people don't like hot drinks in the summer. Mm-hmm. But a lot of offices are cold.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. You're okay. Drink your hot tea, and you can always put ice in it if that's something that's important to you. One thing that I want to start out with, reflecting on our schedule and how things are working for us. And one of the good beginning places for that is William Glasser with mm-hmm. Reality Therapy. Okay, he has kind of a handy dandy formula that I want to share with you guys, and it's called the WDEP model. W stands for want, D as in dog, stands mm-hmm. for the direction that we're moving currently. E is an evaluation, and P as in Paul stands for plan. The reason that you want to try and engage in this little counselor exercise is you need to know how things are working.
That's a great point.
You can't change something if you don't evaluate it. So think about what you want. So for me, you know, I want to be able to better manage my schedule and not have so much clutter in my head. Mm-hmm. Are you type A organized, or lean more towards the scattered side, just naturally?
Well, so the whole type A, type B, I feel like I don't really fit into that mm-hmm. either category. I guess that I have a type A tendency yeah. where I have to absolutely write things down. I have a mm-hmm. planner mm-hmm. and it's actual paper, and I have to be able to cross things
Me
off
too.
My list.
I have an actual yes. paper plan. Okay. Mm-hmm. That's yes. something I was going to talk about.
Yes.
Okay.
But I have learned, and I think it might be that I do have the type A tendency where, you know, if something was supposed to be scheduled and it didn't happen, I've just kind of had to get over it mm-hmm. because that's going to happen a lot. And so I've had to just kind of learn to roll with it. And if things get added to my schedule or taken away, you just deal with it and try not to let it affect the whole rest of your week.
Yes. That's a really good plan.
Thank you.
Yeah. So using the paper planner is something that I do feel is a lost art.
Yes.
I am not naturally organized. Mm-hmm. That is something that I work to do because I see value in it.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And I'm always trying to learn new skills and new ways of organization.
Yes.
So stuff in my calendar, I even try and use colors.
That's smart.
So I can see, do I have one color and what?
Yeah.
I'm a very visual person.
Yes,
and I had
me
to
too.
Go, I had to get off using the phone because everything, you know, in iCal or iPhone was a bunch of dots.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
Right. I have to see.
What?
And mine, you know, has the tabs. And so then I have
yeah.
the month view and then my daily view.
Yes.
And so that really helps me be able to conceptualize, like, this is a really heavy mm-hmm. week. I should stop planning things for this week and move that to another week.
Yes. Mm-hmm. I do that too. And I even have a section in mind that what's asking me what's for dinner.
That's nice.
Yeah. I don't always fill it out.
Yeah.
It's a good thing to do yes. when you're meal planning. So you have what you want. What I want is to, you know, plan better. Then D, you know, direction is, you know, what am I doing right now? Well, I'm mm-hmm. moving in a lot of different directions. Mm-hmm. I, you know, don't have one set place where I am for 40 hours a week. Mm-hmm. So you got to, I'm in a lot of different locations. Mm-hmm. So I have to accommodate for that. That's not going to change. So it's important to note what's going on. And then I evaluate it. So how am I doing right now? Well, it's some, I have to say honestly, you know, I've dropped some balls. And it's like, okay, I've got to, you know, why was it that I did that? Mm-hmm. What happened? You know, okay, well, I'm overbooked. And so I've got to figure out, like you're saying, maybe I need to move that off this week. Yes. Or someone calls me, it's like, hey, let's get together. I'm like, yes, do I have time?
Yes, and I think that that's important because a lot of times I want to do things. I genuinely love spending time with people and people that I haven't seen in a while. Mm-hmm. And some people get a little offended if you say, yes, I'm free, and then it's 3 weeks from today. But to me...
I just did that.
Yes, but to me, that's what makes it work. It makes it happen. That's what you got to do.
Well, you don't want me to show up frazzled.
Exactly.
You know, like
it's not valuable time if you just shove it in when you have an hour free.
Yeah, and that's it. Well, time's up. Great seeing you. Right.
I would much rather be scheduled in than on a timer.
Yes, mm-hmm. me too. Mm-hmm. Okay, so that's something that you guys can look at. And then P is plan. What can I do differently? What can I change? What am I going to try? So many people just kind of get in their habits and they don't try new things.
I think that I'm guilty of that.
Well, it happens. Mm-hmm. So what's something that you keep holding on to that maybe you need to tweak?
So I think that, and I have been in this habit since college, I guess. I really value my personal time in the evenings, like at night. And so even when I was in college, you know, people would go out and I would just be that lame person. It's like, we didn't schedule this. And I don't think that I'm up for leaving the house at 8 p.m. to go do something and then come back and then your next day has started off wrong. Mm-hmm. So I'm not very flexible in the evenings and I do overbook myself. But if it's something that's, you know, kind of spur of the moment and it's late in the evening, I'm pretty much going to just shut it down, which I could be missing out on a lot of good things that way.
But you're protecting your downtime, which sounds like it's something really valuable to you.
That makes me feel better because I do try to jealously guard some of that time.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. No, because that, I'm glad that you even brought that up. This is not planned or scripted. We're just having tea and talking to you guys at home. But I did want to talk about that one of the ways that you can plan better and take some stress off your plate is to think about your priorities and your values. Mm-hmm. And do they match your schedule?
I think that's a great point.
Yeah. So mm-hmm. what you're telling me is, yeah, this is something that's valuable to me, having my downtime. You know, you talk for a living, and there can be a lot of stress in your job because you're dealing with the public.
Yes.
And they're going to be stressed out because...
It's the worst, the hardest times in their lives.
Yes.
And that's when I get them.
Be in front of the judge.
Yes, it's really difficult.
Yeah, mm-hmm. And so that's a lot of pressure. You need to definitely have time.
Well, and I think that if it's something that makes you the best version of yourself, that's what I've been trying to aim for the past several years. If it makes me the best version of myself, then I feel like it's okay.
Yes.
If it's something that I'm just, you know, doing out of obligation, but I feel like it's not adding value to my life, mm-hmm. I try to figure out a way to kind of, you know, get that out of my schedule a little bit more.
Possibly a guilt.
Yes.
Initiated.
Yes.
Task.
Yes, because that was a really big thing for me all during high school and even a little bit into college is because mm-hmm. I'm a people pleaser.
Sure.
And I love having my schedule packed. I love having activities to do. Yes. Because I feel effective and, you know, it's some good experiences.
Yeah.
But then it just gets really out of hand. Mm-hmm. So definitely getting those things out of the picture that I'm just doing because I feel obligated.
Right. That's good. So another thing that you look at with the priorities and your values, you know, which for me, and I've mentioned on the show before, you know, family time, mm-hmm. You know, work for the family. I do the PR for the farm. And that's going to be a priority because that's a family business. And then the other paying jobs that I have are a priority. But then, you know, I just want to go ride my mule sometimes.
Right.
And while it could be, oh, you know, you should do laundry instead, or you should clean the house, you know, sometimes I just have to say, it's going to have to wait, those kind of like daily tasks that you could do all day, every day, because dirt just comes right back.
Yes.
I have to say, I'm going to stop right there, and I'm going to go ride Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. And that, taking that time for myself, refreshes me. Mm-hmm. And I, even though I took this gap, I come home, I'm like, I'm ready.
Right.
I can do this now because I've given myself a little bit of time. I wasn't, you know, getting paid to do it. Yeah.
I think that makes you much more effective in whatever you're going to do, because then you're not so weighed down when you're actually doing the laundry or cooking dinner or whatever else it may be.
Yeah, and getting also, if you have really high expectations for yourself, mm-hmm. I do think it is important to try to, you know, attempt movement. But if you set a really high perfectionist level, that sometimes done is better than perfect.
Yes.
Laura Casey says that. She's somebody that I follow online. Do
you introduced us to one of our books in book club.
Yes.
Loved it.
It was called Make It Happen.
Yes.
It was a really good book. And that's one of her sayings, done is better than perfect. Mm-hmm. And I like
that's good.
And I try and use that because I can, you know.
Well, I don't know about you, but I have a constant flow of at least 4 to 5 to-do lists going at any given time.
Or you are type A. You have 4 or 5.
Yeah,
there's categories of lists.
I did. There's categories of lists.
Now I'm going to have to, try and
analyze
do this.
Me. Yes.
No, I haven't. You know, I'm not naturally organized, so I'm like, maybe that's my problem, is I need categories of lists.
Well, I'm sure if my mother's watching, she will say that I'm not organized.
No.
But I think that she is just overly organized.
Oh.
But you know, those tendencies are great. She's the most effective, efficient person I know.
Mm-hmm. Mention who she is for the two people that don't know.
The two people that don't know, go pay your taxes. My mother's Deanna Rains in the trustee's office here. So she's really the most organized person
on the
planet.
She
would be. And has to be. You're right. Has to be for her job.
Absolutely.
But there are certain things that I am organized in. So I've got to have my checklist. Mm-hmm. I don't know if that's so much organization as, you know, I just love the feeling of after I get it done, I get to check it off.
Choo!
Done. But then other areas of my life, like keeping my shoes organized, for instance. Like, no, it's just mass chaos.
You know, my closet can go in a dark direction.
Yeah, mine too. And Brad is also very organized.
Really?
I'm surrounded by all these organized people, and it's exhausting.
Oh.
Katie, it's exhausting.
Oh, dear.
Yeah, yeah. Because to me, I think I'm like you. There are certain things that are not as high on my priority list as others.
Right.
And they just get overwhelming to me, and then I just don't do them.
And I think that happens to a lot of people. Mm-hmm. There's this another book, since we're talking books, by Jen Hatmaker. Oh, what's it called?
Yes.
I sent it to you.
Yes, she did send it to me. Something with the ring or something.
For the love.
For the love.
Okay, that's good, because we're live. Anyway, she has this metaphor for walking on a balance beam. And saying that in order to make it across, sometimes you just gotta toss. Mm-hmm. And so she looks at her life and says, you know, what is on the beam and what is off the beam.
Uh-huh.
And I think that's what you're saying is, you
it
know
is.
What, this for me is off the beam. And I look at that for my life and think, you know, what are some time wasters that need to be off my beam so that I can make it across this thing.
I think that's a good point. And so I think that's something that I should work on, because there are some things that are probably off my beam that maybe need to be on, and things that are on that need to be off.
Right. Good point. Mm-hmm. I don't think she talked about that.
Jim, put it in your next book.
Yeah, it should be on your beam that aren't there. But it is, it's, you know, it is a balancing act. It's a juggling act, just trying to make it through.
I once asked an attorney, actually, Jennifer Mitchell, who's Jessica Austin's sister.
Yes.
She is an attorney, and she has 5 children.
It's amazing. Amazing.
Yeah, and so I asked her, and I was new to practice, I'm still fairly new, asked her how she managed, you know, to do everything, just to get everything done.
Yeah.
And she said, it's a juggling act. I just have balls up in the air, and, you know, I catch them as they come, and... I just get things done. But she does it so effortlessly. And so, of course, you know, Brad and I hope to have children one day.
Yeah.
But right now, everything is in my calendar.
You're still so new.
Yeah,
you're
and my calendar here is just booked.
Yes.
Solid.
Yeah.
So it's definitely going to take a lot of self-reflection to figure out, you know, how do you best manage your time? And
yes.
So the other, one of the other partners in my firm, her name is Elizabeth Greer, your cousin.
Yeah. All in the family.
All in
Let's
the family.
Just be family.
Okay. She, of course, has three small children as well. And she is really good at managing her time and is really mm-hmm. open to reading articles and books about how best to manage her time. Mm-hmm. And so she gives me good insight too. You know, she actually, when she's at work, it's her practice to, like, a couple of hours a day, she'll just block out and just hammer through work and not check email or anything.
Oh,
because,
that's a good strategy.
Right, because then it's easy to get diverted off, you know, on different tracks.
Mm-hmm.
And so I think that that's pretty applicable to life, too. Like, if I can just concentrate on a couple of tasks and get those done,
yes.
then it makes it less overwhelming.
Yes, because I can get off course. I can mm-hmm. be headed to one thing and then see another thing. And,
yes.
And now I'm doing a little bit of a lot.
Exactly. I find myself doing that often.
Yes. It's just the natural way that I am, but I mm-hmm. know that, you know, behavior-wise, it's good to try and
yes.
evaluate how that's working for you and try something else.
Yes, I agree. Okay. What do you suggest for that? When you're evaluating yourself and trying mm-hmm. to figure out what works and what doesn't, how do you do that? Do you put it on paper?
Well, if I have a lot of time, I would love to sit down with a journal and a cup of tea mm-hmm. or something and just have a quiet moment where I think about how are things working? How are things going? And I do search out times to do that. Sometimes I'll, mm-hmm. you know, take quite a bit of time and think about my goals, things mm-hmm. that I really want to be focusing on right now. You know, we did an episode with our pastor, Greg
yes.
Smart,
mm-hmm.
and we were talking about, and that's why I mentioned it, is because it was July and I was doing my goals for the year or for the next 6 months,
right.
actually. And it's weird that people don't usually do that in July, but this is one of the ways that I kind of keep my time focused. Now things pop up. Things come up in mm-hmm. your life that you weren't expecting, and then you have to reorganize, mm-hmm. resort. And I also think about how I'm personally doing. If I'm, you know, suddenly stop sleeping, or, you know, I'm feeling overly fatigued,
mm-hmm.
or I notice that I'm stressed out, I try and input things to make my life a little easier.
That's
you
a
know,
really good idea.
Some people, that may be to get a housekeeper.
Yeah. That's a really good idea. I really like that
yes.
idea. My
well,
husband's watching.
Me too. There's nothing like walking into a clean house. Because uh-huh. to me, cleaning is so futile. You know, you clean it, and being married to a farmer, it's having all the animals, it's like,
yes.
oh, that's dirty 5 minutes later.
And
it's frustrating. If I didn't clean it,
they change clothes all the time.
Yeah.
I didn't know until I got married that men change clothes all the time.
Honey, I got to tell you what you need.
What?
Two washing machines.
That's a. Do you have two washing
oh my
machines?
Oh gosh, yes. Okay, so I had one break.
Uh-huh.
And it was leaking water. And so I moved it into my garage. Who cares if it leaks some water
right.
in there? Got a new one. And
that's
so
a
I
really
have
good
a,
idea.
I have a two washer and dryer. So, you know, dog stuff or stuff that perhaps
right.
you pulled a calf in.
Right, exactly. That's what I'm about to say.
That you don't want to put your personal mm-hmm. delicates in after that. So,
yeah.
yes, two washing machines.
That's a great idea because, you know, after Brad Weed eats or whatever, it just gets grass everywhere.
Yeah.
It would be awesome to have a separate
right.
machine for that.
Mm-hmm.
We have two freezers, but not two washing machines.
Okay, that's great. right now they're at home. They're like, great, thanks.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's just looking at things to help mm-hmm. you out, to make your life easier, like Blue Apron. Hey,
yes.
I mean, we talked about that last week.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I just said, ship me some food.
Well, because
I'll try it.
Right. Like you said before, I enjoy going to the grocery store.
Mm-hmm.
But I enjoy going to good grocery stores.
Mm-hmm.
So that means that I have to set out time to go to Chattanooga and go to the store.
It's time commitment. Even if you go like to Sam's to get bulk, which I recommend for, you know, time management and having a stockpile of things like toilet paper.
Yes, exactly. My mom and I recently got a Costco card, and that's really fun.
Fancy.
Mm-hmm. And so, but I enjoy going.
There's time.
But it definitely, you know, time gets away from me.
It's a Saturday.
It's a Saturday.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And you've lost it, but yeah. So sometimes, just figuring out, you know, how to make it work for you.
Right.
That's how I do that. Mm-hmm. I just see how can I make Katie's life easier, and sometimes you just can't.
Work smarter, not harder.
I know. I spend a lot of time figuring out how to not work. Right. So hard. I haven't achieved it yet, but you know, I always end most episodes with saying, how do you personally live well? Mm-hmm. Do you have some ideas that you'd like to share with the people at home?
Well, I really enjoy my time with Brad. So I've been trying since we've been married, whenever he's not working. So Brad works night shift, by the way.
Hard.
Yes. So we are on totally different schedules. I live in the daylight and he does not.
Yeah.
So whenever he has days off, we really like to spend quality time together. Mm-hmm. So there's been a lot of times where if we're at home, we kind of put our cell phones to the side and just spend time together.
That's a nice strategy. Mm-hmm. A lot of people don't do that.
Because then it feels like the time that we do have together, even if it's just maybe one good solid day per week, you feel like you've actually gotten to be together for a long time. Yeah. Because you don't have so many distractions.
Because it was quality.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I like it.
And one thing that I need to practice at being better at so I can live well is not overbooking so much on the weekends. And
Do you mean like with activities with friends or family? Or
Both. Or
like mundane tasks like grocery?
All of the above.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. All of the above.
Me too.
So, well, and Brad and I don't really mind to do mundane tasks together. Like this past weekend, Labor Day weekend, we worked at our house almost the whole weekend. But at the end of it, we were so exhausted, but it was lovely because we had just spent that time together, investing in our home and working really hard together. But I tend to overschedule us because I really enjoy spending time with friends. But I do tend to, you know, have us booked out for quite a period of time. And I think it is important for us to just have time on the weekends.
One-on-one.
And just then spend time with our families as well. And fortunately for us, our families, my parents and his parents and my siblings, all get along really well.
Yeah.
So we can a lot of times get together as one group.
And have a really fun family get-together.
Yeah.
It's an advantage.
It is an advantage.
Okay. So I think those are really important things. And we talked about earlier how you have your personal time.
Yes.
That you, you know, keep in the evenings. Mm-hmm.
And I know that our pastor, Greg, talks about contemplative prayer and meditation.
Yes.
And so that's something that I would really like to get better at and engage in because it does make a huge difference.
Now, do you write your prayers down in a journal?
I have in the past.
Okay.
And again, it was not beautiful, like flowing prose or poetry.
No.
It was literally a checklist of people I needed to pray for. And I would check them off. That's how my brain is wired.
Well, you know, you said you'd pray for them and you made it a point to pray for them. But so, I write down my personal prayers, or at least this is an attempt to do that. And I was told that, you know, by doing that, you can go back and look at how, you know, God answered them over time.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And it's a nice reflection moment. So that's one of the things that I do to de-stress is I feel like, well, you know, I've turned it over to God and I've asked him. And sometimes that happens multiple times a day where I have to remind myself that I am letting God take care of this and I need to stop dwelling on it, you know, where your mind just kind
of
chews.
It takes a lot of energy to dwell on things like that.
Yes. Mm-hmm. It's just like a cow chewing cud in my brain over and over and over when something really matters. And it's distracting me from what's in front of me.
Yes.
Like yesterday, meeting with clients, you know, I'm worried because my daughter has a rash. Mm-hmm. And so it's hard for me to segregate and say, okay, you know, we're I'm focusing on you. I'm not thinking about her, you know, or what I need to do.
I think it's very important to be able to compartmentalize, and mm-hmm. I'm just learning how to do that. A good friend of mine that I roomed with in college kind of taught me how to do that. You know, that it's very important to, when you're at work, work and work your hardest. Yeah. And when you're at home, kind of set that ball up on the shelf mm-hmm. and be at home.
Right. But it's hard. It's mm-hmm. hard to figure out which ball you're playing with.
Yes,
because it's a juggling act, mm-hmm. and then you have to pick one. You have to pick one that's, you know, most important at that time.
Yes.
And sometimes on your list, you know, prioritizing mm-hmm. which list is most important for me to do now, and which right. task is, you know, most important.
I think that that's been something that I've been trying really hard at, and so far it's been working well.
Yeah.
Is that when I'm home, I am home and I take a break.
Yeah.
You know, there's a difference in working weekends, which is fine, you know, if you've got a big case coming up or whatever. But when I am at home, I, unless there's an emergency, I leave work at work.
Yeah.
And otherwise, I think that I would just burn out.
So work quick. All the time. And you mm-hmm. do have to be careful about that. Mm-hmm. Burnout is very high in both of our professions.
Yes, exactly.
Oh. Well, Cara, I really appreciate this time together and for you coming on the show.
Thank you for having me.
Absolutely. A lot of good things to share with you guys at home. And that's all the time that we have for today. So I'm going to hope that you guys this week will take time to live well. Thanks.